everyone. Today's topic is GIS for public policy. Geospatial information is data connected to a geographical location. Once the data has a geographical component, you can place it on a map to visualize the data. GIS, or Geographical Information Systems, captures, stores, analyzes, and displays geographically referenced information. You may have heard of a company called ESRI. If not, it is a company that makes GIS software called ArcGIS. Most GIS professionals use this software program to create these data-driven maps. To give you a quick look at what I'm talking about, let's take a look at some sample data-driven maps on the ESRI website. This is the link on your screen. There are various interesting examples, and we're going to pick one to take a closer look at in a moment. So, if you click on View the Maps, you'll bounce down to some really interesting example maps that they have here. All of them are GIS maps created with ArcGIS. If you click on, let's click on Housing with Mortgages and View Live Map. You will see that this is an interactive map. So you can zoom in and zoom out. And you can also click on a particular area on the map to find out what the color coding, more about what the color coding means. It gives you a sense of that down here in the legend, that the darker the color, the higher the number of housing with mortgages. But if you click on a segment on the map, you'll see the box pop up on the right. More information pops up about that region, in particular the county. So it's an interactive map, and it tells a story. This map shows you by county the percentage of housing that is owned that has a mortgage or loan out of the total number of housing units in the county. This map could also be an indicator of homes with a risk of potential future foreclosure. Maps showing foreclosures could also help with understanding things like foreclosure patterns and whether proximity to foreclosed properties has an effect on property values. As you can see from this example, GIS has a lot of potential use as a public policy tool. The federal government and policymakers increasingly use GIS for producing things like floodplain maps, viewing census data, mapping foreclosures, viewing the impact of congressional redistricting, and responding to natural hazards such as wildfires, earthquakes, and floods. Next, let's take a look at some more sample public policy maps on the ESRI website. So from this page, we'll pick a category. We'll pick healthcare. So you can see these maps related to healthcare legislation, need and access to healthcare, and factors that affect health and Medicare. For policymakers, these types of analyses can greatly assist in clarifying complex problems that may involve local, state, and federal government. Let's take a look at Where Are the Uninsured? This map compares the lack of insurance to possible factors such as race or income. Again, we have a legend with color-coded legend, and you can zoom in and zoom out on the map, and click on data for your county again. And so, for example, 25% of people in Grand County, Colorado had no health insurance in 2005. You can see how this could be really useful for policymakers to know this kind of information. The power of GIS is the ability to combine geospatial information in unique ways, by layers or themes, and extract something new. So, GIS analysis might include overlaying data on the path of a tornado with geospatial data on the types of structures encountered along that path, such as homes, stores, schools, post offices, etc. And this could inform an analysis of what types of building construction can survive high winds and hail, or what level of emergency response might be needed and where. Now back to this map that we're looking at again one more time. It has separate tabs up at the top. You can click on, for example, Hispanics or income and see if there's an issue related to race or income related to the uninsured. So as it says here, there's an expected correlation between income and health insurance coverage. And the data reflects that. Now, as an example of how a congressman has used GIS, we're going to take a look at Senator from Idaho, James Risch's website. Underneath his Idaho info link, you can find an Idaho map gallery. His website has a whole gallery, as you can see, of maps related to things of interest to his constituents. For example, areas in Idaho where there's drought, issues with drought. Just wait 1 second to pull up an example here. So he's overlaid drought data on top of a satellite map, and he's listed his sources on the left as well. So he's using NOAA data, USDA data, and drought mitigation center data. He also has things of local interest like Idaho farmers markets, EPA cleanup sites, and active wildfires. This one's interesting because it uses real-time data. So it's streaming data to show current wildfire areas. Just give it a second to load. This one looks like it's a little bit slow to load today. So hopefully this presentation has given you a good overview of some of the capabilities of GIS and public policy research. You can explore the ESRI website for more examples, or you can look for other GIS maps using a Google image search at images.google.com. Hi everyone, today's topic is GIS for public policy. Geospatial information is data connected to a geographical location. Once the data has a geographical component, you can place it on a map to visualize the data. GIS, or Geographic Information Systems, captures, stores, analyzes, and displays geographically referenced information. You might have heard of a company called ESRI. If not, it is a company that makes GIS software called ArcGIS. Many GIS professionals use this software program to create these data-driven maps. To give you a quick look at what I'm talking about, let's take a look at some sample data-driven maps on the ESRI website. There are various interesting map examples we can look at on this page. So we'll scroll down, take a look at housing with mortgages as an example. I'm going to go to view live map and wait for it to load. As you can see, the legend at the bottom center shows the colors on the map darkening in counties with higher densities of homes with mortgages or loans. You can zoom in and zoom out here and pan. So let's take a look at a segment in Washington, D.C. area. So if you click on a map segment, a box will pop open about that region. So it's obviously an interactive map, and it tells a story. This map shows you, by county, the percentage of housing owned that has a mortgage or loan out of the total number of housing units in the county. This map could also be an indicator of homes with a risk of potential future foreclosures. As you can see, a GIS-made map has a lot of potential use as a public policy tool. The federal government and policymakers increasingly use GIS for producing things like floodplain maps, viewing census data, mapping foreclosures, viewing the impact of congressional redistricting, and also responding to natural hazards like wildfires, earthquakes, and floods. So let's take a look at some more sample public policy maps on the ESRI website in just a moment. Let's take a look at some examples on the public policy maps page under the healthcare tab this time for something different. One map that looks interesting here is the Where Are the Uninsured map. It compares the lack of insurance to possible other factors such as race or income. So if you scroll down, you can again see the legend shows that the percentage without health insurance is color-coded, so with increasing lack of insurance is a darker shaded area. And you can click on the tabs up at the top where it says Hispanics and then income to see whether there is a relationship between uninsured and race or uninsured and income. And as it says on the left, there is an expected correlation between income and health insurance coverage on this map. And again, you can zoom and zoom out, you can pan, and again, you can click on a particular area and get more information about that county. So for policymakers, this type of analysis can greatly assist in clarifying complex problems that may involve local, state, and federal government. The power of GIS is the ability to combine geospatial information in unique ways by layers or themes, as in this map, and extract something new from it. So GIS analysis might include overlaying data on the path of a tornado with geospatial data on the types of structures encountered along that path, such as homes, stores, schools, post offices, etc. This could inform an analysis of what types of building construction could survive high winds and hail, or what level of emergency response might be needed and where. Now, as an example of how one particular congressman has made use of GIS, let's take a look at Senator Risch from Idaho. Take a look at his website, because he has a great collection of such maps under his Idaho Map Gallery page. Now, his maps on his page are obviously going to show things of interest to his particular constituents. So, for example, he has one here on active wildfires in Idaho, and that's using real-time data from USGS. There's drought areas in Idaho. Let's zoom in on that particular one for a moment. So he's overlaid data from the National Drought Mitigation Center, and USDA and NOAA data are all layered here. And you can see the intensity of drought conditions in the area. So you can take a look and browse through some more of the kinds of maps that he lists here. He also has EPA cleanup sites, Idaho farmers markets, wildland fire potential, and so on. So I thought that would be interesting for you to take a look at. At any rate, hopefully this presentation has given you a good overview of some of the capabilities of GIS for public policy research. Feel free to explore the ESRI website for more examples. You can also find examples in lots of places. The New York Times in particular likes to use GIS maps on their website. And you can also take a look at a Google image search. It's just images.google.com, and you can search for any topic along with the words map or GIS and find a lot of great examples. So I hope this has been interesting. Please let me know if I can help you find any more information related to GIS. Thank you.